Tes, tes.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. A very good evening to everyone. Okay, how are you guys? Can you hear me?
Waalaikumsalam, Doktor. Ya.
Waalaikumsalam, Doktor.
Waalaikumsalam. Loud and clear.
Okay, Alhamdulillah. Good. Alright, so currently kita ada 66 participant and counting. Okay, so we just wait for a few minutes. Okay, and maybe around five minutes, and then we will start. Okay.
Sure, no problem.
Okay.
Okay, Doctor.
Thank you. Okay, again, Assalamualaikum and a very good evening to everyone. Okay, so thank you for being here. We currently have 120 participants. Okay, so of course it will increase. Okay, as time goes by. Okay, again, I like to share some housekeeping here. As I mentioned last week, our session we will take attendance for the session, but the attendance form will be given to you after 9:30. After 9:30, okay, 9:30 p.m. or around maybe 75% of our session. Okay, so once we complete the 75%, and then we will actually share with you the link, and you can actually fill up. All right. And once we get the video recording for tonight, we are going to upload it, okay, to YouTube, and we are going to share with your zone leader, and then your ketua zone will actually share with you in your group. All right. Okay, so without further ado, okay, I would like to actually share for tonight we have two presenter, me myself and Dr. Umar. Okay, but the first round, there are two topics. Okay, one is a demonstration and demo dan pendaftaran sistem idkpt.my. Okay, so I'm going to show you the step by step how the system works and how do you actually get yourself registered. Okay, and you can actually use it. Particularly, we are targeting four person, which is the supervisor and also three students, okay, in this case. All right, so the next one after the demonstration and the registration of the system, we are going to show you Dr. Umar will share with you, or I already mentioned during briefing on the 28th what are the expected output that expected from students and from supervisors. But this time, Dr. Umar, we will go, we'll elaborate more with regard to the kajian case, the digital poster and video story. Okay, so he will actually explain to you what are the specific things that are required, specific element, okay, that are required. And that will be the second session for tonight. All right, so are you ready, guys? Can we proceed? Am I loud and clear?
Yes,
Doctor. Yes, Doctor. Okay.
Okay, good.
Yes, all right. Good.
Okay, thank you very much. So, if let's say, I noticed there are some names here, now some of the participants here, please make sure that you don't put numbers in your name. Okay? Put your name, and then your university, and then which zone you are from. Okay, for example, if you are just now like Izati, okay, _ or Izati UMK, East Coast, something like that, so that we can identify you. Okay, because last week I had issue on the number, people putting just number. I asked many times to actually change the screen name. Changing the screen name, you don't need to log out. You don't need to log out to change the screen name. You just go over your name, okay, over using your mouse, and then you will see there's a button, ask to unmute and more. Click more button, and then you can change rename over there. Okay, no need to log out. No need to go out from Zoom and then come back again. No need. This is, Zoom is very friendly. So they allow you to change. So it will directly reflect the name, the new renaming will be reflected exactly right after you change it, you press the button. Okay, so no problem. Okay, all right. So let me, okay, somebody is raising hand. Who is it? Mr. Saha, you raise hand. Any question from you before we start? Okay, you are still raising hand. You want me to lower your hand? I can lower it for you. But normally, yeah, if in physical, you cannot lower people's hand. It's like, hey, too much. Okay. All right. Okay. So we start, eh? Okay, so the first thing that everyone need to do, okay, is actually to know where is the system. Okay, so where is the system? Okay, no, no quiz, eh? If there's any quiz, if it's like, if it's face to face, I will give some chocolate and so on, eh? Where is the system located? May I know the URL, the address, uniform resource locator, URL? Anyone knows what is the URL for our project? Anyone? Can anyone tell? Do you remember the URL? Okay, so it's ideakpt.my. Okay, ideakpt. Yes, thank you very much. All right, so we have. Thank you very much. Okay, Tara. Tara is very active, eh? Since last week, eh? Tara Zainal from UMS. Oh, UMS, eh? Wow. Okay. I missed to go back to Sabah. All right. Okay, so ideakpt.my. Eh? Okay, so what we do, I'm going to change my screen so that we can see my browser, so we can actually start with our sharing. Right. Okay, everyone can see this, right? Okay. Just ignore my face over there. Okay, maybe it's all right. Okay, so you can see this. Okay, the first thing is actually later on. I think most of you have already been familiar with the system. Okay, with the website, they have our key impact indicator, timeline, toolkit. About for the time being, the most important part here is the about because you have your training schedule and so on. Okay. You can explore on that, no problem. You just spend a little time, okay, for you. Normally your generation, okay, you have can actually do it in like lightning speed. Okay, I believe in that. All right, so if you see here on the right side, okay, let me just move mine. Is it blocking? I think it's blocking, right? Okay, hold on. Let me change the. This another way of doing it. Hope it will work. I'm not sure. Oh, it's the same. Okay. So here on your right side, okay, on your right side, you can actually, okay, you can actually see a button, okay, bookkeeping system, eh? Okay. Let me just make it a little like this. Okay, you can see bookkeeping system over here. All right, so bookkeeping system, of course, we wouldn't be able to put bookkeeping system, logbook, case study. We cannot put everything in one name, so we put bookkeeping system. So you just, when you click bookkeeping system, okay, so the system will bring you to this screen. Okay, so this is an interface of how it looks like. Okay, we change a little bit here, but no problem. The most important thing here is you see, click here to log in. All right. Of course, now you are not logging in, but we just click. Okay, if you click, you can see. All right. Okay, let me just show you first, and later on, you go one by one. I will tell you how to do. And later on, you can try it on your own, okay? Because some of the information you need it from me so that you can register, okay? So I will show you first round, eh? I will show you how to create account. Okay, so both supervisor and also students, similar, it's the same. Eh? The only thing, I'll give you a code later. Okay, so creating an account is simple. Okay, just click this button at this link here, create an account. Okay. My mouse is giving me problem. Okay. So create an account here. When you click create an account, there are several information here that is required. Okay. Firstly, your username. Okay. Username, email, registration code, and actually password. Let me just clean this one first, then you can see what is behind there. Okay. So username, email, registration code, password, and confirm password, and I agree with the terms and condition. Okay, you can read the terms and condition if you want, but no problem with that. Okay, so the username is your name. Okay, your username, short one. No. For example, you can put Aziz, for example, Aziz, and then you can put aziz@gmail.com. Okay, registration code. We are going to give you registration code. I'm going to give you later. But let me just go through how to use this. Very simple. Registration code. Once you have your registration code, okay, we give it to you. One registration code for supervisor registration. Another one registration code for student registration. Okay, one each. Okay, so please don't, as a student, don't use the supervisor code. As a supervisor, don't use the student code. It is dangerous. Okay, otherwise you will have a different role. Okay, so later on you put your password. Both this one should be the same, and put agree and submit. Okay. Okay. Once you submit, you will be brought to this screen. Okay. So you will be brought to this screen, and let me just show you. I've already registered as a supervisor. Let me just log in as a supervisor. So this is my name, Zaidi. I log in as supervisor. I sign in. Okay, once I sign in, I will get this dashboard. Okay, so sorry, I get this interface, and there will be one dashboard here. So zero total supervisee. I don't have supervisee. No message, no, and so on. Everything is zero lah, because this is income and so on. All right. So you can see there are a few on the left pane here. We have business. If you click the arrow, you have add button and manage business, add business and manage business. And you also see, let me close this one. And then student attachment, you click, you can see supervisor and company. Okay. Student progress is display progress for logbook. Okay. And the other one is user profile. Okay. User profile. So because you just log in like this, I just log in, I just sign up, and then I just sign in. What I do is I go to my edit profile, and I will change my picture. I will put my name. Okay, the honorific is there. Just choose yours. Okay, put your name here, your email address, which institution are you from. Just choose. Very simple. Okay, so all these institution currently we use from the registration, from your registration. Okay, if let's say you have issues, that means your IPTA is not there, don't worry about it. Okay. Don't worry about it because most of the, like 2 or 3 days ago registration, you may not have your university, but it's okay. You can actually choose for the time being, and later on we will actually, you can actually edit when we add the list. Okay. And your phone number, and then you update. Okay. So once you have this as a supervisor, once you have that information completed, okay, we require you as supervisor. Once you have that complete, the other one is to actually add business. Okay, to actually add business. So if you see here, if I put manage business, okay, it's empty, right? I don't have anything here. Okay, because I haven't registered anything yet. If I go to dashboard, even we have some of it. Okay, my profile is complete. This one is not complete. Eh? Still not complete. Add business request for supervisor company is not complete at all. So then what I do, I can add business. Okay, for supervisor, if you notice here, you are required to put the real business name. Okay, the real business name here. If you don't have it now, you can edit later. Okay, you can edit later. The most important thing is for you to update your profile for the time being. But if you have the business information, mostly, most of you already pass it. I think nearly 70% MSE is already in the system. I mean, it's already known and given by every university. Okay, it's nearly like 70-71%. Okay, so we have the name of MSE, which was given by the IPT, the university, or has been registered with us. Okay, but with the contact of a supervisor, connection supervisor and the MSE, you can actually get from MSE because they are close to you. So let me just show what is what should I register. Okay, I'm going to get some information here, which I already get from my I already prepare and then I put Eclipse Enterprise, that's the name of the company. Okay. All right. And then registration number for the time being, I don't know. Okay. Because I didn't ask. So I just put JM123. This one, no problem. You can put first. The most important thing, having the right business name. Okay. Why is it very important to have the right business name? Because later on, when student register and sign in, they will need to choose, okay, the business name, which is the supervisor have to tell the students what are the business name, okay, so they can choose actually. Okay, so there will be a lot of interaction between you and your supervisor and student currently lah, at this time. Maybe you can later on when we do this, you can WhatsApp your student and tell. Okay, and then business category. Okay, she's doing food, okay, food and beverage. Okay, so here, okay, this one also you can just put it simple one. I can actually put food. I just put food. You must remember later on you can actually change it, you can edit. Okay, so it's not a big deal. The most important thing is to put the information, whatever information that you have first. Okay. Enterprise, product owner. Okay, he's the product owner. Okay, this one, marketplace. You can choose many. This is actually considered as a tick box. Okay. She actually sell it in Lazada. She actually also sell it in social media. She also sell it in on website. She also sell it in others. Okay. So, and then we put the email address of the owner. Okay, and then we have the website. Okay. So I just copy this. I put Facebook first. Okay. Instagram. Yes, Instagram. Okay, WhatsApp for business, she uses the mobile number. Okay, because the website don't have, so I just put this one. This one I have to cancel. All right. So even the WhatsApp using the same phone number. Very simple. Okay, so just register the business. So I click the button, register the business. Okay, so now in the business, okay, when I manage the business as a supervisor, I can see the business is there. All right. So if I want to edit, I can click this button. You can edit. No problem. If you want to trash it, you can trash it. Okay, no problem. All right. And then here, you see, as a supervisor, the next function is actually a student attachment. If you click student attachment, if I click supervisor here, all right. So, okay. This is a mock. Just actually my daughter. I use my daughter's account. So my daughter here, she's a student actually. So when she log in, she apply. She choose me as a supervisor. All right. So what I do, I can approve. I can click this button for approval. All right. So, but I'm not going to approve lah because this is just to show. Later on, I'm going to approve the real one when my student actually registered. Okay. And then for company attachment. Okay. Company attachment is way. Okay. Here is empty because students, your students have to log in. Once your student log in, they will actually see when they choose their supervisor. Okay. They will actually see. They will actually hold on. Just Shuhada, just wait for a while. When they choose their supervisor, they will actually see also see the list of the business, so they can choose. Once they click the business, it will appear here too. Okay, Shuhada, if the company doesn't have any FB, social media, and so on, WhatsApp address, just put not available. Okay, Najmi, Najmi is my developer. He said put dash also okay. Okay, dash or not available. Okay, because we believe this program is way, yeah, Tara also can, not N/A, it's okay, no problem. As long as you put, I recommend to put something like NA, okay, or not N/A, something like that. Because later on when we go through, let's say I want to do some data cleansing, I can actually see. Okay, so this program is actually meant to help the entrepreneur from your. When you go over there, you imagine they have zero. They have zero social media. They have zero FB page. And suddenly you come, you change. You will be very happy, right? Okay, they will be, wow, I know I'm very happy. I'm already in the social media Facebook page. It's not social media profile page. Okay, all right. And then later on, we have also marketplace. Later on, we learn marketplace, Lazada, Shopee, and they will also have that. All right, student progress is actually on the logbook. Student progress on the logbook. This one, student haven't key in anything. Okay, so they haven't assigned me, so I cannot see lah. But later on, we are going to see it. Okay, so supervisor, that's all. That's currently what you need to do. Okay, and the next step will be once your student choose you, there will be another step. Okay, so any question from supervisor? Any question from supervisor? That's simple, right?
Okay, yeah, but too.
Yes. Any question? Hold on, let me check in the chat. Okay. From this every state, we need to put the MSC div test. Yes, Zaidi, correct. Yes.
All this registration is only after we get the number from you, right? The code from you, right?
Yes, correct. So I'm going code, to give the code. I'm going to give the code in a few minutes.
Oh, it means you will be given now, not in the email or?
No. I'm going to give you now, so you can get. If you have a notebook, if you have notebook or desktop, it's easy for you to register lah, because bigger screen. If let's say you don't have it, okay, it's okay. You can actually copy the key. I'm going to give you the key, and later on you can do it. But I suggest you as a supervisor, you do it now because your student will need to choose you. Okay, otherwise they don't have parent, they don't have a supervisor. They will become anak yatim. They don't have supervisor. Okay, so because supervisor is actually the umbrella. Once the supervisor is there, supervisor will put business, and when the student go in, they choose you. They will request you to be their supervisor. Then you approve. Okay, then you can see the things running lah. Okay, all right. Okay, we don't have any question there. Okay, so I'm going to share the the key to supervisor. The key is very simple. Okay, again, let me just log out and show you again. Sign out. Sorry, this is not login, log out. This is sign in, sign out. Okay, so. There's a lot of different ways of doing. Create account again. Let's go here. So this is your username, okay? And then this registration code for supervisor. Okay, supervisor. The code is here. The code I paste it in the chat. Can you see? Okay. Alright. So you have the code over there. SV, you can also see in the screen lah. SV and so on. Alright.
Dr. Zaidi. Sorry yes. to disturb.
Okay.
I think maybe someone accidentally opened their mic.
Okay. So please, okay, let me just, very simple. All right. Okay, so make sure don't you mute your mic, eh? If you need to actually say something, you can unmute, and also you can actually chat. All right, please make sure you have the SV, okay, SV25461KL, eh? Okay. Okay. So for supervisor, you can start registering now. Okay. So while the supervisor, your supervisor is registering, now I'm going to show our students. Okay. Okay. Are you ready? Oh, students always ready, right? Especially this generation. Okay. All right. So student ready. Okay, Sheila. Thank you, Sheila. Balkis, Sufyan. Yes. Correct, Balkis. All students will get the same code. Okay, but you have your different email, right? So your email is unique. Okay. All right. Okay, ready, eh? So for student is the same. Okay, if you go to IdeaKPT website. Okay, IdeaKPT website. So there will be a button here, bookkeeping system. Okay, click the bookkeeping system. Again, it's the same. Oops, why is it taking time? Okay, let's have a drink. Maybe some water. Okay, sorry, eh? All right, so again, create an account. It's the same. Okay, the only difference is I'm going to give you the later on, before I give you the registration code, I'm going to show you how it works. I directly go to I think the registration is simple. Okay, so I'm going to log in as a student. I'm using my my daughter credential. Okay, so this is the view, the interface for a student. So here, what you need to do as a student is the same. Go to your user profile and edit your profile. Okay, edit your profile. Oh, okay, I already edited. I put my daughter all the real information except for the email. It's my own email. Put your picture and so on. Anyway, you can edit later, but make sure you have all the information, especially your full name and so on, because it later on it will appear in the supervisor's request. When you request for supervisor, when the supervisor log in, they will see your name over there. Okay, so make sure you know who's your supervisor. Okay, everyone should know who their supervisor. Eh? Okay, if you don't know who's your supervisor, please talk to your lecturers. For example, if you have like two teams, most of the university have two teams, six students, two supervisors. So there must be one supervisor for three students. Okay, but if let's say they don't know whether they want to go to supervisor A or B, please talk with your team first, okay, and later on then you request, okay, talk with your lecturers and so on. Okay, so once you do the profile, okay, you complete that profile, okay. Okay, you go to student attachment. Okay, this one I'm going to show you later, but you go to student attachment. Once you go to the student attachment, okay, you click status. Eh? You click status here. I think this one I already choose. Ah, okay, okay. So this one I already choose, eh? Waiting for approval. Okay, so let me check. Okay, so select supervisor. They are so many already. So we have Dr. Karim Benzema, Dr. Amar Ramli, Dr. Adila, Roy Yosu, all already here. So many here. Okay, so then we can choose lah. For example, you see the list here. If you see, oh, that's my supervisor, you click. Okay, of course, this one is already select. But if you don't have this, that means you are still not having any supervisor. You click the name and then there will be a button here. Okay, request. Okay, company, if the lecturer, if your supervisor already list down the company, so it will be also in the list here. Okay. Okay, it's also in the list. Like this lah, just now I had Eclipse Enterprise, so I can click Eclipse Enterprise. All right. So make sure you talk to your supervisor. Okay, hold on. Let me refresh and see. Okay. So now I don't have. Okay, backend already kill. Kill the company. Can you please help me? Okay, Najmi will kill. Will delete the. So here I put. Okay, you see, send request. As a student, when you click send request, they will ask you a question. Are you sure once the request has been submitted, you can't change the supervisor anymore? So think about it. Okay, correct. Then you send request. Once you send request, it will go to the supervisor account. But for your case, it is waiting for approval. All right? So this one also, I select the company. We have many already. Okay, I select company Eclipse Enterprise and then I send request. Remember, when you click this request, it's not sending to the company. It's sending to your supervisor. Okay, your supervisor is the bridge for you to the company. You must understand that. All right, so send request. All right, so now you are waiting for approval. Okay, so please approve me and so on. Don't worry. Okay, your supervisor will approve you. We don't want any haywire, for example, somebody sent to you and suddenly you don't know them and so on. We don't want that to happen. That's why we have this. Okay, while waiting for your supervisor to approve it, okay, let me show you. This is for student. Maybe some of lecturers wants to know because you have to show also to your lecturer later on if you have your supervisor. Sorry, you have to show your supervisor if you have any question. Okay, for example, bookkeeping. We can help in this system. You can actually do adding transaction, which is one is sales and one is expenses. Okay, when you click add transaction, you will be given this interface. Okay, so this interface number one on the left side is actually add sales. Okay, the other one expenses. So let's say at that day, the company just now I'm what they call Eclipse Enterprise is selling something. What date is today? Third. So first you have to know whether it's online or offline. Maybe it's offline, okay, because you just started with them and then they say, I don't know offline lah. I don't know online lah. I only know offline. It's okay, sir. It's okay. We are here to try to help. And then later on, what we can do, we try to help you and bring you to online. It's okay, but we need to help you to record. So when you put offline, this will be disabled lah, because there's no platform. We know it's offline. Okay, so that means somebody come to the shop and suddenly somebody come to the shop on the 3rd of June. That means today, and they buy maruku 3 pieces times 500 gram. You must remember. This is actually not like an inventory system. We don't go into that level. Okay. Later on, the most important thing is recording. Okay. So the entrepreneur will understand the importance of recording. Okay, we in this program we need you need to actually tell them, okay, to have a record in place. Don't just get some money and then give the maruku and then later on I will record. Don't do that. Otherwise, you will forget. Okay, people are busy and then their mind keep on thinking a lot of things and so on. So amount, okay, maybe 10 ringgit, so 3 is 30 ringgit. Okay, so you see, the Najmi make it very special here. Okay, you can see automatic is 300. You press, then you submit. Once you submit, okay, automatically it's refresh. Okay, you can actually look here. When you look at manage sales, okay, and then you have offline maruku, 3 pieces times 500 gram is 30 ringgit, right? So you can see here. Hold on, I have question. I have question from lecturers from UITM. Hold on, Okay, Dr. Zuraida from UITM, right? Okay, so it's okay. You can choose others first. Later on, what they call we'll add the what they call the list, and then later on you can update your profile. Okay.
Sorry, doctor. So others because
not others. So, you can choose maybe UITM and so on for the time being.
It just like, said there UITM Ta'alang, Penang, Penang and Permata Pau.
Boleh.
Okay, yes, thank you.
Later on, once we update, okay, we are going to you are going to inform lah, because or if we don't inform, you can go and change your profile yourself. Okay, Najmi is adding now. UITM Sabah, Najmi will add now. Later on, when you refresh, you can see the list.
Okay, we have thank you.
Okay, thank you, madam. Okay, all right. Okay, cool. So no one else. All right. So and then the other one is expenses. Okay, you can see add transaction. So let's say this owner is actually purchasing. Maybe she pays for some delivery charge. Okay. So the expenses, because the maruku is 30 selling for 500 gram 10 ringgit times 3, but she actually cover the what they call a delivery charge lah. So delivery charge. Eh? So petrol, for example. So and then it's the same day. So we put delivery petrol bike. Sorry. Bike rider for delivery. All right, so it's like, for example, 2 ringgit.
Ah.
Okay, submit.
Okay.
All right, okay. Okay, so now if you go here, you see manage expenses. Manage expenses. You can actually see this part, okay? And the 2 ringgit and then the... Here on the top, okay, on the top also there's a 2 button, view sales and view expenses. If you click view sales, okay, you can get the sales. View expenses, you can get the expenses. Okay, so if you go to dashboard, you can see the overview. Okay, you can see. So there is 30 ringgit sales, 2 ringgit expenses for this month. It's actually in the rank month. They put it in month. So they were actually 1 transaction of sales just now. Okay. Can eh? Okay, for logbook. Logbook. For logbook, you see, okay, add activity. All right. So let's say you start on the 3rd. Okay, you talk to your to the knee. So the description is, I just give example. Online meeting with entrepreneur and entrepreneur share all the digital pictures of products available. Aha. Okay, so discussing blah 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 and so on and so on. Okay, and then we have maybe 1.5 hours, and then you put remarks here. Pictures need you put remarks yourself need to be edited. Okay, for better presentation. Kan nanti kita ada kelas kan? Kita ada kelas on apa nama orang cakap? Kita ada kelas on the design and so on. Okay, so pictures ni ada yang dah siap. Jadi mungkin kita boleh edit. Tapi if we can take pictures on our own and so on, okay? Or we get we can actually even teach our usahawan to take pictures. I experienced that lah, very funny. But it's a good way in digital. And then I submit. So then I can see the logbook is there lah. Manage logbook. I can see. All right. Oh, of course. This morning I already put online meeting with supervisor, MSC, and so on. So later on we'll add. We'll have the sum lah. Later on we'll add a function of how many hours. Remember, you need only 40 hours. Minimum 40 hours lah. 40 hours. If you need. If you want to, let's say you have more engagement, no problem. You can put it. You can put it your logbook here. You can put it. You can add more because the most important thing is do recording. We have to practice recording. Okay. All right. And then okay, that's all for case study. Last time during briefing, I show you right the snapshot. We pull it out first because we are going to revise. We're going to revise. So later on, when you log in these few days. Maybe you can see what are the things there. All right. Okay. So I'm going to share with you. Is it okay, students? I think students can't wait. Oh, they can't wait to actually see. Let me just sign up here. Yes. Okay. Thank you, Fatiha. Okay. I'm going to share with you this one. Okay. No need for you to look at it. I'll just copy here. So, okay. Student key, they call it. Student code. All right. ST. Oh, this is like Tawau. It's a car from Tawau. Dr. Ana, betul ya, Dr. Ana? Sandakan SS, this is Tawau. Okay, ST91124GH.
Betul.
Nah, betul Okay, so please. Please play around. I mean, students can just go and then make sure you have your yes, Mr. Zul. Username tak payah nama penuh. Zul. Username you just put like you put you punya username macam Zaidi. Okay. Setakat ni tak ada orang lagi guna kot sebab sistem dalam sistem ni saja. Okay, so not a big problem lah. Okay, so make sure you the username you remember and also you remember the password. For the time being, please don't forget. Okay. Okay, so make sure you have it. So I'm going to log in as a supervisor just now and I want to see whether the kucing lapar. Bukan kucing lapar. I have so many cats actually here. Okay. So dia sudah makan tapi dia mau gaduh. Okay, ini kucing memang Ilmi ni memang memang pakar psikologi kucing kot. Dia tahu. Kita ada seorang student yang kucing punya expert kan? Daripada poli ke mana? Saya lupa nama dia. Email syarikat tu, if you go into the business profile of syarikat, okay? If you go for your profile, is your email lah, okay? Doktor veterina kot, okay? Funny lah y'all ni. Alright. Let me just go. Sekejap lagi kita siap. This one tak banyak susah lah. Mana tadi? Okay. Let me tutup this and then.
Dr. Zaidi?
Yes, saya. Dr. Sam.
I have questions regarding the business registration number kan. Is it compulsory for all business to have that kind of registration number?
Okay, if they register in SSM, Okay, mm-hmm. Dia ada tiga number lah. Satu is, oh sekarang dah baru seorang. Sekarang ada kod baru eh. Sekarang ada kod baru lagi hebat. Dia tahun, lepas tu bulan, tarikh registration, lepas tu dia punya nombor. Dia panjang lah nombor dia. Katakan 2021-05-16 May kan? Uh-huh. And then dia ada nombor-nombor. Okay, kalau PLT, ada lain sikit lah. Tapi dia sebenarnya, dia baru tukar dia punya standard. If let's say you punya company tak ada, okay, mm-hmm. just put not available.
Oh, boleh eh?
Boleh. But, okay, this is what I want to advise. Eh?
Okay.
We like you to actually talk to you, the talk to the micro, because mm-hmm. we are dealing with micro and small. Uh-huh. Talk to the micro and small and tell them during this period, eh, mm-hmm. you become close to them. Bagi tahu dia kepentingan ada benda ni. Just to share with them, I have experience when I talk to them about SSM, mereka tak nak sebab mereka cakap kena bayar tax.
Yes, yes. Uh-huh.
Alright. I can talk to you, I can tell you how it works, okay? Kena bayar tax ni kalau you cukup syarat minima, you perlu kena tax. Kalau tak, tak cukup. Alright? So, yang itu pertama. Yang kedua, apa nama? Kalau dia tak register, sekarang ni banyak kerajaan bagi dana. So dana-dana ni hanya untuk orang yang register SSM. So nanti dia tak dapat, dia rugi. So dia ada plus minus lah di sana. Kalau dia tak nak bayar tax tapi dia nak untung, dua-dua, I think mungkin tak sesuai lah duduk di bumi ni. Sorry cakap.
Okay, doktor. I will talk to the I will ask my MSE dulu, tengok macam mana. Mungkin kalau dia ada, then I will add up lah. Kalau dia tak ada, then I will advise.
Kalau dia tak ada, for example, some of our friends in Sabah, they may not have SSM punya registration. They can use any board, any organisation. For example, in Sabah, they use Majlis Perbandaran. Okay, MPKK, MDKK, Majlis Bandaraya, MBKK, Majlis Bandaraya Kota Kinabalu.
Dewan Bandaraya Kota Kinabalu.
Saya dah lupa sebab saya dah lama tinggalkan Kota Kinabalu eh. Saya dulu lama sana. So dulu MPKK, zaman-zaman saya muda lah, tahun 92, 93, 94, MPKK lah. Okay, so sekarang dia apa?
Dewan Bandaraya.
Dewan Bandaraya. Okey, DBKK. Ada mayor lah ni kan. DBKK lah.
Yes.
Okey, Dr. Umar tahu sebab adik dia kerja sana, dia selalu pergi. Alright. So apa nama, kalau ada any body organisation eh? Okey, Tara cakap MPKK before 2000, MPKK before 2002. Oh, thank you very much. Alright. So once
Doctor, anyone from UNIMAS?
Yeah, anyone from you? Ada, saya dah nampak tadi. Anyone from UNIMAS? UNIMAS pun ada pelik sikit juga dia punya UNIMAS, Sarawak
I
pun.
I think Kuching, I'm not pretty sure, but Kuching for the enterprise or they need to register with sama juga municipal council, but for the Kuching for Kuching punya district tu kena register dengan, if not mistaken, dengan LHDN.
Kuching
sahaja. Dia pelik sikit.
Okay.
I'm not pretty sure, but that back in 2014-15 lah masa saya ke sana.
Okay, so this one I think every place know, and then even kita, saya dah bagi taklimat hari itu kepada pengarah kesohanan, dan even taklimat yang ada dana, you must remember. Tapi the dana is not for the company, eh? The dana is not for the company. The dana is for you as a you yourself as a student. If you berminat, which is we encourage you to register SSM lah, okay? Atau register dekat municipal council, kita bagi the funding. Okay, Dr. Mahani cakap tadi it applies for all in the state of Sarawak, the whole. Sekarang panggil state ataupun wilayah Sarawak and Sabah. Okay. Okay, Dr. Sina, UPSI, UPSI registration business under SPPP. Apa tu SPPP, Dr. Sina?
Skim pendaftaran perniagaan prihatin.
Yang percuma SSM tu eh?
Sebab dia kalau kita pergi ke EasyBiz dalam website SSM, dia akan ada dua tick dekat situ. Jadi kalau student, tick pada yang SPPP tu. So that dia yang percuma.
Okay, sebab kita ada juga dana yang yang percuma, yang 10 tahun, 10 juta tu diberikan oleh SSM. Still running eh? I think this year is the fifth year, I think. pun percuma juga pendaftaran individu atau perkumpulan. Okay, so I think just a few ringgit lah kalau nama perniagaan ataupun nama sendiri. Nama perniagaan dia akan bagi free lah. So ada beza kan, berapa ringgit saja beza. Okay, alright. So hold on, let me check. Okay, you can see here. This is supervisor. Just now I mentioned ada student yang hantar ni kan, hantar request kan. So I check supervisor. Let me check. So I had this Nur Ariana and so on. Okay, business company. Pun I boleh approve lah. Okay, so I'm waiting for my student later on. Okay, mana saya punya WhatsApp? Okay, I'm going to WhatsApp my student so that they can register dia punya ni lah. So so for you supervisor, you can actually talk to your students and you under your supervision, okay? And then sorry, I'm sending a message to my team. All right. Okay, so okay, any question? Any question? If let's say you have any question you want to ask, okay, let me check. Somebody is asking, chatting something. Huruf besar. Huruf besar, what do you mean huruf besar? This one. The code. Yes, huruf besar. But correct. They must be exactly. Uppercase kena follow. The case kena follow. 911 ST Sierra Tango 911-24 Golf Hotel. Okay, so make sure you have it. Yeah, just copy and paste. Betul. That's why saya tak nak you tengok di screen saya tadi. Nanti you type susah. Saya copy paste for you. Easy. Okay, hold on. Let me show another one. This one you can play lah. You can see. Okay, just now.
Dr. Zaidi, minta maaf. Ada soalan.
Okay.
Tadi student saya kata UiTM Seremban tak ada. So boleh letak dulu UiTM mana-mana. Nanti baru update balik ya.
UiTM. Okay. Ada student ni seorang daripada Seremban kan? Tapi you punya
betul. UiTM Seremban.
Region Penang kan?
Saya Penang. Student saya daripada tiga cawangan. UiTM Penang, UiTM Seremban dengan UiTM Puncak Alam.
Yes, betul. Saya nampak tu. Nanti boleh apa tadi nanti Puncak Alam,
UiTM Puncak Alam, UiTM Seremban.
Okey, ini tadi. Nanti Najmi nanti.
Okey, bye.
Puncak Alam Seremban. Betul eh?
Betul UiTM Seremban.
USM, ya betul. Afzan, USM pun sama eh? Sebab USM kita baru yes, nanti USM akan masukkan. USM kita masukkan. Okay, USM kita masuk. Thank you very much, inform.
Okay, satu lagi Dr. Zaidi. Tadi saya tengok dekat part student yang untuk logbook tu kan. Sebelum ni pun, kami saya dah buat meeting dah bersama pelajar dan SME tu. So boleh masukkan yang tu sekali lah.
Boleh. So kalau you dah kick off awal, boleh. So yang penting student lah. Macam saya tak bawa student lagi jumpa. Okay. So diorang tak ada, tak ada interaction. So diorang tak tulis logbook lagi lah. Tapi saya dengan usahawan memang saya dah jumpa lah, tapi saya tak ada logbook. So the most important thing, the you together memang you boleh record, no problem.
Okay. Maksudnya kalau tu lah, saya kan takut bermula pada hari ni, taklah sebelum tu.
Tak, you boleh start, tak ada masalah.
Okay.
You all dah initiate awal-awal, it's okay. Okay, but once the system is there, just use the system to record lah apa yang you dah buat. Okay, so saya rasa tak ada banyak benda lah.
Doktor nak tanya.
Yes, silakan.
Student dia punya yang list institution tu dah ada ke UiTM Sabah? Ada pelajar saya tanya.
Macam mana? Ulang balik.
Yang list of institution for my student, dah ada ke appear yang UiTM Sabah?
Oh, me dah update ke me? Dah ada. UiTM Sabah dah ada.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Boleh bah kalau kau. Orang cakap macam tu kan. Okay. Dr. Rozaina from UiTM. Doctor, to add business, what if the company to be registered still does not have a website? Mentoring. Okay. Tak apa. You can put NA, doctor. Not available. Just put NA. Okay. I recommend to put NA. Okay. Just put NA. Alright. Okay. Anyway, I think website ni... dalam silibus kita tidak ada cover website. Okay, sebab website ni consider as something yang you establish then you have. But it's possible too. It depends on you guys punya initiative lah. It's beyond yang kita ajar. Okay, sebab kita ajar ni more on using social media, Instagram, Facebook, and then you use your punya Puan Mariam, nanti saya bagi. And bila pergi website ni, normally it takes more. I mean, the website is owned by the company, and they require to actually. It's not free lah. They have to buy the domain name. They have to hosting and so on. Okay. Puan Mariam nak maklumat MSC tu eh? Puan Mariam, saya WhatsApp eh. Alright. Nampak semua chatting. Satu Malaysia nampak. Okay, tapi tak ada benda yang ni. Okay. Saya try register admission. Itulah error. Title error. 3 kali cuba. Error apa eh? Dr. Mahani, boleh tak share?
Dia keluar fatal error ni.
Okay, tak apa. Macam ni. It's okay. What we are going to do nanti. Okay, USM, UiTM Puncak Alam dan UiTM Seremban dah masuk eh. Dalam drop down boleh ambil. Okey, Dr. Mahdi, nanti dan semualah. Lepas ni kita akan adakan satu WhatsApp group untuk system error. Any system issues, kita panggil system issues eh. So, Najmi, saya punya developer, Encik Najmi akan buatkan satu WhatsApp invitation link. Okey. So, kita akan share. Kita akan share pada ketua zon, okay? Dan ketua zon akan share pada semualah. Okay? So, kalau ada mana-mana error, kita just tekan WhatsApp tu, terus masuk dalam group ataupun masuk dalam directly kepada Najmi. Lepas tu boleh snapshot error tersebut bagi pada dia. Okay? Cepat. Dan kita juga akan masukkan invitation tu dalam web lah. Tengok macam mana eh. Sebab kita sebenarnya nak minimiskan ada nombor personal dalam web. Kalau tengok dalam web kita tak ada personal number eh. Kita tak ada buat personal email. Email dengan number kita tak letak. Kita tak nak nanti ada orang ganggu siapa-siapalah. So kita respect PDPA, kita respect eh. Personal Data Protection Act kita follow. Hold on.
Dr. Zaidi, sorry mengacau.
Ya.
Yeah. Nak tanya, kalau macam yang MSE tu dia boleh diisi kat mana eh? Dia ada daftar tak?
Sorry, again?
Untuk syarikat MSE,
mm-hmm.
Dia kena daftar ke dalam dashboard tu?
Dia kena daftar. Ulang, saya tak faham lah.
Tadi saya dah register untuk jadi SV. Kemudian student pun akan register. So macam mana dengan yang syarikat tu, yang yang MSE?
Okey, register jadi SME maksud dia?
Kita masukkan data kan, ada data MSE tu kita masukkan. Am I right?
Kita yang masukkan data MSE. Data MSE kita masukkan sebab dalam akaun ni, dalam akaun sistem Idea, kita hanya ada dua user, satu student, satu supervisor.
Okey, baik. Okay. Maksudnya SME jadi tu bila, tak ada kaitan lah, tak ada dengan tak ada, tak perlu register apa-apalah eh.
Ha, kita bila masuk dalam supervisor, saya tunjuk sekali lagi. Katakan bila you masuk as supervisor, you masuk as supervisor kan ada bahagian business profile.
Betul.
Dalam business profile tu lah kita masukkan maklumat MSE.
Kita lah yang akan masukkan. Jadinya, yes, kita masukkan. Maksud saya SME tu tak ada kena-mengena untuk dalam sistem ni eh?
Ada. SME, MSE, MSE tak ada access ke sistem. Dia tak ada access ke sistem. So baik, macam ni kan, boleh nampak eh. Business, kita tadi add, kita add business, kita boleh letak maklumat. Okay. Sebab bila once kita add business ini, then barulah dia akan appear untuk student pilih lah semua ni.
Baik, crystal clear. Terima kasih banyak-banyak. Okay.
Thank you.
Sorry Prof.
Okay, Cik Zul.
Untuk SME tu, saya adalah salah satu SME. So saya dah daftar untuk supervisor. So ada miscommunication sikit tadi. So macam mana saya dah daftar untuk supervisor?
Cik Zul MSE eh? Cik Zul MSE dah daftar untuk supervisor. Nanti bagi saya maklumat email tu. Kita boleh clearkan maklumat tu semula.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, nanti type je dekat dalam chat email yang Cik Zul guna.
Sebenarnya saya punya rakan pun dah terdaftar juga tu yang tanya tu.
Then bagi saya email mereka, nanti kita akan flash.
Baik, clear.
Najmi boleh Najmi? Kena back end lah. For the time being lah. Sebab kita dah ada kesilapan ni. Okay, boleh. No problem.
So, doktor.
Okay, sejam eh. Okay, Siti Rahayu, just untuk makluman, tadi bila saya tak letak FB, Insta, yes, dia memang error eh. Sebab itu wajib diletak. Kalau tengok, semua yang ada star ni, semua wajib eh, diletak. Semua yang ada star ni, nampak tak? Ini semua wajib diletak. Jadi, kalau tidak ada information di sini, kalau you letak Facebook, selamatlah. Kalau you letak NA pun, selamat juga. Maknanya okey. Kalau dia empty saja, dia kira error. Okay? Sebab you tak boleh submit. Okay? Macam kita isi Google Form eh. Okay. Tadi ada soalan? Siapa ada soalan tadi?
Ya, saya doktor. Okay. Ada ni.
Ilmi. Okay.
Saya pun nak penjelasan, masih keliru juga ni yang bahagian yang sekarang ni.
Aha.
Yang bisnes ni untuk okay. SME, untuk SME tu saya yang isi, supervisor yang isi ataupun urusetia yang isi?
Supervisor isi.
Yeah.
Okay. Supervisor isi eh, sebab ada dua saja user dalam sistem, iaitu supervisor dan pelajar.
Okay, thank you.
So supervisor ada maklumat MSE, MSE dan of course ada maklumat sendirilah. So bila log in saja, supervisor update profile, lepas tu update business, add business. Okay, boleh eh?
Dr. Zaidi.
Ya, yes, saya. Dr. Sina, silakan.
Ini, okay. Add business tu maknanya, kalau katakan saya ada 3 MSE tu, saya dah register 3 MSE tu dalam sistem ni, betul?
Supervisor lain tak ada ke? Yang register?
Bawah saya ada 3 orang.
Satu supervisor, satu company saja.
Oh iya ke?
Amboi, banyaknya.
Bukan.
Ini kena bagi kita di company ni. Dia punya pasukan. Oh iya ke?
Nasib baik saya tanya sebabnya diorang kan semua jauh-jauh kan?
Aha.
Nak memudahkan diorang, mana saya dapat info?
Okey, dia macam ni. Doktor, sebelum ni kita wajibkan face to face. Dulu kita wajibkan face to face disebabkan keadaan sekarang tidak menentu. Kalau kita wajib face to face, kita tak akan boleh buat. Dan selepas saya berbincang dengan beberapa MSE yang saya kenal dan juga pakar lah, sebenarnya memang lebih baik buat fully digital. Okay? Sebab apa? Sebab ini adalah platform yang kita boleh belajar apa masalah untuk bantu usahawan dan macam mana kita bantu mereka secara jauh. Jadi for example, ada juga tim kami yang tak silap saya seorang di Sibu eh. Seorang di Sibu, Crystal eh. Student, seorang di Sibu, lepas tu kawan lain di Melaka and so on. Tapi kita company yang sama. Maknanya mereka akan communicate semua guna secara digital. Secara WhatsApp, secara online dan sebagainya. Ataupun email. Okay. Cabaran ni. Sekarang ni cabaran baru. So, Lelong. Oh. Lelong siapa yang nak eh? UTHM okay. Kurang satu.
Dr. Sinar Dr. Zaidi.
Ya.
Yeah. Maknanya lepas saya register tu, yang request for company tu, itu student lah eh?
Student request for company. Student akan pilih company dalam list.
Kalau saya tak masukkan company tu, dia tak boleh pilih lagi lah macam tu kan?
Dia tak boleh pilih. Dia tak nampak dalam list.
Okay.
Sama juga sama juga pencara. Kalau pencara tak register, tak sign in, tak register nama dia, user profile tak ada user profile tu. Actually, nama dia dah ada lah. Tapi kita nak dia semak. Selagi dia tak ada, memang student tak boleh nampak list.
Okay, jelah. Terima kasih.
Okay, Dr. Sina ingat ni.
Bagi team saya.
PM.
Baik. Team, satu team, satu MSC, satu supervisor yang mana mereka berkenal lah. Dan tiga pelajar. Okay.
Doktor.
Okay, silakan.
Doktor, yang ad business tu kalau saya belum siap hari okey ke sebab dia nombor registration dia tak ingat, besok boleh bagi tahu.
Apa? Puan boleh letakkan je nombor lain.
Oh, nanti, just letak nombor lain dulu.
Nanti boleh edit. Nanti puan pergi manage business kan. Puan isikan semua ni, masukkan semua maklumat ni. Kalau katakan ini tak betul eh. Katakanlah dia ada nombor macam Johor, dia ada JM kan. Katakan tak betul, letak dulu. Semua ni isi, lepas tu register. Nanti puan masuk balik, login balik. Bila pergi manage business, puan boleh edit. Tekan button edit. Puan boleh tukar di sini. Bila dapat dah maklumat tu. Lepas tu tekan button update.
Okay. Thank you.
So kita mudahkanlah. So kalau maklumat tu dah ada, malam ni terus masukkan semua. Satu je maklumat tu edit, jadi tak perlulah start balik kan daripada awal besok. So tinggal satu je. Nah, Dr. Dila raise hand. Oh, Dr. Dila raise hand. Takut saya orang raise hand ni.
Assalamualaikum Dr. Jadi.
Waalaikumsalam.
Kat mana kita nak tengok notification yang student request for approve tu?
Dekat sini, student attachment.
Student attachment eh.
Dekat. Now, screen saya nampak eh?
Nampak.
Masih nampak eh? Student attachment.
Dan dekat supervisor tu.
Tu dah keluar dah. Okay.
Kalau saya belum ada ni, maksudnya dia orang belum isi lagi lah ni.
Dia tak isi lagi.
Okay, alright. Thank you.
Bro.
Okay, Dr. Zaidi. Untuk logbook student, dia orang kena isi individual kan? Bukan by group kan? Setiap orang kena isi tak?
Sorry?
So, again? Logbook student. Okay, dia orang kena isi, setiap seorang kena isi kan? Bukan
yes,
wakil
betul.
Kan?
Betul. Setiap seorang kena isi logbook.
Okay.
Case study berbeza. Case study Najmi. Kita kena revise. Tak apa. Nanti saya inform. Sebab kita tengah buat revision untuk case study.
Boleh.
Nanti kita akan masukkan modul. Nanti boleh nampak lagi. Your profile is not complete. Your full name is not there. Nanti you completekan eh.
Yes.
Okay. And then
okay.
Satu lagi doktor, bila yang request for company tu, maksudnya saya kena approve yang tiga-tiga tu lah kan? Betul tak?
Yes, betul.
Okay.
Macam sekarang ni saya approvekan pelajar yang pilih saya. Okay?
Okay.
Jadi and then bila saya pergi attachment this company, bila saya klik, saya akan nampak juga ini tak ada. Tak nampak lagi. Ini belum pilih lagi ni. Tonton, saya rasa tuan tak ingat. Okay, alright. So, I think should be okay. Kalau ada ada issues and so on, nanti kita share link untuk apa. Kalau memang tak sabar-sabar nak tanya, bolehlah hantar isu tersebut ke ni dululah, ke Ketua Zon. Okay, nanti Ketua Zon akan hantar pada saya, and then nanti kita akan rectify. However, nanti kita akan sediakan satu link dalam WhatsApp invitation untuk record ataupun raise issue, apa-apa isu lah. Okay, so whatever it is, saya cadangkan kalau ada apa-apa isu, error, snapshot. Ambil je gambar snapshot, jadi boleh submit ke melalui WhatsApp. Jadi kita nampak error tersebut. Jadi kurang sikit lah nak explain. Kalau tak penat, kesian you all nak explain. Okay, banyak lagi kerja nak buat. So biar part-part yang ini kita handle lah. Alright, Prof. Kalau ada sales, kena ada bukti apa-apa. Okay. Ini soalan yang baik, soalan daripada Damia College Community Langkawi. Soalan dia, kalau ada sales, kena ada bukti apa-apa tak? Receipt contohnya. Okey, saya cadangkan, kalaulah awak anda boleh dapatkan dia punya receipt, okey, for example, bila bersama-sama dengan usahawan tu, okey, sebab you nak key in kan, you nak key in, bagi tahu tuan, kalau ada apa-apa receipt yang tuan ada, kami tolong key in kan. Macam itulah. Saya pernah buat dulu semasa program Women in Social Enterprise. WISE, Social Enterprise. WISE, kita pernah buat. So, isu yang paling besar sebenarnya memang mereka tidak ada receipt. Mereka tak ada receipt. Mereka jual, mereka jual runcit. So people datang bagi shilling, takkanlah budak-budak beli aiskrim 20 sen bagi resit, lepas tu datang lagi budak 20 sen bagi resit. Memang susah. So apa yang makcik akak-akak ni buat, dia catatkan dalam buku, tetapi pun terlepas pandang. So ketika tu kita ajarlah kepada, kita ajarlah bagi sedikit ilmu. For example, tak perlulah puan catatkan aiskrim tu setiap kali orang beli. Tapi you boleh buat, katakan pagi, daripada pagi ataupun batch, satu batch ada 100 batang aiskrim Malaysia yang harga 50 sen satu, katakan tengah hari, by tengah hari kira berapa balance. Okay, so berapa orang bayar lah, itu satu cara. Tapi dengan syarat orang tak ada kehilangan lah, sebab isu dia orang hilang, anak cucu dia sendiri pergi ambil aiskrim. Okay, tak bagi tahu dia lah, dia tak bagi tahu opah dia nak dia ambil aiskrim. So benda-benda ni berlaku, dan ini adalah sebenarnya kontrol yang perlu dipraktiskan oleh family lah. Dia perlu bezakan antara perbelanjaan peribadi dan perbelanjaan syarikat. Even suami datang, ini depan mata saya, suami datang dengan motosikal, bagi tahu, bagi RM1 nak pam minyak motor. Dia ambil je duit daripada laci, tak ada cash register, bagi pada husband dia. Saya tengok dari jauh, langsung tak catat mana-mana. Mungkin dia catat dalam kepala lah, tapi tak boleh. So bookkeeping ni maknanya merekodan ni adalah satu benda yang penting. Okay, so Damia, kalau memang ada receipt, itu memang baik. Kalau tak ada, it's okay. Kita perlu minta apa orang cakap, perlu mereka ada awareness. So discuss dengan supervisor macam mana you nak deal dengan MSC lah, sebab benda-benda macam ni perlu adalah orang kenalkan. Macam saya akan kenalkan student saya pada company lah, jadi kita boleh duduk bersama bincang benda ni. So benda ni bukan melibatkan 3 bulan dalam program ni saja, benda ni akan ubah cara micro usahawan berfikir. Alright, Damia, thank you for the good question. Okay. KK Langkawi ni buat tourism kan? Bila you start dengan attach dengan usahawan? Itu kita kena. Once you start attach dengan MSC, then kita kira you punya sales. kalau belum ada F&B. Okay. Kalau dah start dengan usahawan, okay, then you boleh kira sales. Anas Zikrullah.
Dr. Max.
Yes, silakan.
Satu soalan saya, Amar Rais.
Okay.
Untuk yang request for company ni.
Aha. Hold on.
Bila kita klik tu,
request for company, okay.
Kalau kita attach student tu, nama dia akan keluar kat situ lah kan?
Betul. Sekali kalau kita attach,
kita boleh attach terus student ni sekarang ataupun kena tunggu tarikh tertentu nanti?
Boleh. Kalau for example, kalau dah ada MSC, kalau katakan dah register company kan? Dah register MSC, student dah terus boleh pilih.
Oh, okay. So, saya terus boleh tindakkan dia terus kan maksudnya ni?
Boleh. Boleh. Okay. So, nanti dalam sistem kita dah ada record, yang the only thing is sebab kita kena align sistem dengan real. Kan? So, dalam sistem dah ada record, tinggal berjumpa dengan usahawan je lah. Interact dengan usahawan untuk mulakan. For example, dah boleh mula lah kalau nak jumpa kami. Yalah, saya pun tahu supervisor jumpa MSC bagi tahu kita ada program sebegini. So saya punya MSC pun dia dah tak sabar lah nak buat nak tengok apa benda nak bantu dia. Macam tu lah.
Okay, noted, understood.
Okay, thank you. Dr. Irini, UITM, right?
Yes, UITM Shah Alam.
So, nama tak ada sebab Dr. Irini tak register. Dr. Irini kena daftar sistem dulu. Supervisor perlu daftar dulu. Sufian, nanti kena inform supervisor. Okay, boleh, Sufian?
Boleh.
Mungkin Dr. Irini tak ada malam ni. Okay, Dr. Nur Fatihah, Dr. I have a question. Tonight briefing should be added dekat logbook for student and confirmation or lecturer should be added. Okay, logbook tak perlu isi malam ni. Logbook ni lebih pada you all punya, tadi saya tunjuk contoh saja. Okay, logbook tu lebih pada nanti bila you buat interaction dengan you punya, apa nama, MSC, usahawan. Okay, sebab this logbook is considered as you punya attachment. Tindikan dengan usahawan. Okay, so satu pelajar 40 jam. Okay. Alright. All lecturers should be added dekat logbook. Saya tak berapa faham soalan. Okay. Dr. Olin, thank you. Dah daftar. Okay, Fatihah. Okay, thank you. Alright, so I think maybe we stop sini sebab saya akan pass pada Dr. Umar. Okay. Saya dah ambil banyak masa dia ni. Okay. Nanti anything again, kita any issues jangan segan. Kita nak make sure everyone we start good, okay, with good foundation. So nanti record apa semua kita lengkap. Jadi bila you all nak tengok record pun, you tak perlu nak call, email dan sebagainya. Everything on the system. Okay. We want to make it that way. Alright. So the reason for the system, everyone knows lah. We want to have it as a repository. And Shahira, thank you Shahira. Tak bagi attendance saya akan bagi sekarang. Okay, is for the repository. Okay, so once you have the repository and all the information there, so bila-bila masa pun you boleh log in selagi sistem tu ada sana lah. Okay. So before I lupa what you do untuk pengetahuan semua, link untuk kehadiran ni ada pada training schedule Kita akan buat sebegini setiap kali. So kalau kita klik malam ni is bookkeeping sales bookkeeping sales expenses reporting. Klik sana. So turun ke bawah ada button link for attendance. Klik dekat sini Okay, saya akan on sekarang for you to key in lah. Thank you for reminding me. I appreciate, man. Sorry, saya punya umur dah meningkat. Lupa pula. Tak cukup omega. Ini berapa hari bulan? 3. Okay, I'm going to switch on the form so that you can put your kehadiran. All right. Okay, and at the same time, I'm going to copy and paste it in our chat so that easy for you to just. Okay. Thank you, Shaira. Okay, so I think that's all from me. Okay, for this part. Okay, so anything, any issues and so on, please snapshot. Any error, please snapshot. And apa yang tak faham, tak apa, boleh tanya Ketua Zon. Nanti kalau Ketua Zon boleh jawab, dia jawab. Kalau tak, dia akan pass untuk kami discuss dalam grup Ketua Zon. Okay. Alright. So, okay, thank you. Saya dah dapat Kelvin Tiong dah. Dah ramai dah masuk ni. Nabila Syekh Razainan. Dr. Razainan dah masuk. Okay, alright. Good. Okay, so I'm going to pass to Dr. Umar. Dr. Umar? So,
okay, Dr.
Okay. Umar, boleh? So, you are going to share your screen?
Okay.
Kejap, or you want me to share the slide?
Dr. Disable. Disable participant screen sharing.
Oh, okay. Sekejap. Saya disable eh?
Ya,
eh? Okay, dah. Saya dah bagi one participant share at a time. Boleh tak you masuk?
Tak boleh, Doktor.
Tak boleh?
Doktor just klik kat situ. Klik dekat share screen tu. Doktor allow. Yang belah atas, Doktor right click dekat share screen tu.
Aha.
Doktor klik situ and then ada satu function, ada bulat tu untuk allow participant to share screen.
Boleh tak? Saya dah buat.
Boleh.
Okay, alright.
Okay, sebenarnya Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan selamat malam, salam sejahtera saya ucapkan kepada semua mentor, para pencara daripada semua IPTA, Politeknik dan juga College Community, seterusnya kepada para pelajar. Dan saya difahamkan pada malam ni juga ada juga MSE yang terlibat sama malam ni. Adakah para usahawan yang terlibat sama dalam taklimat yang dibuat ni?
Ada yang volunteer datang ni, bagus mereka.
Ada, ada. Kena paksa datang pun ada.
Saya okey, terima kasihlah kepada yang hadir. Saya akan mengambil sedikit masa sahaja. Sebenarnya benda ini telah diulas pada oleh Dr. Zaidi pada meeting yang pertama. Cuma kali ini kita cuba perhalusi tentang pelaksanaan yang yang lainlah. Okey. Attendance tak polisi. Saya rasa attendance maybe Dr. Zaidi kena open kepada non UTM kot. Ada kata tak lisi tu. Okay, jadi sebenarnya malam ni saya nak fokus kepada kajian case and then after that saya akan fokus kepada poster digital dan juga penyediaan kepada video. Tiga benda lah, okay. Nanti kita akan fokus lagi pada satu iaitu penyediaan report. Tetapi untuk malam ni tiga benda, sebab apa benda ni dia dah kena, data tu dah kena collect the moment para pelajar buat engagement dengan MSE, okay, micro small enterprises. Sebab tu kita kena brief apa data yang perlu diambil lah. Okay, kalau ada soalan terus direct je kita buat informal. So saya faham yang sebenarnya kajian kes ni sewajarnya dibangunkan, sewajarnya lah, maksudnya tanggungjawab tu terletak kepada para pensyarah. Memandangkan kita ada lebih kurang berapa Dr. Jadi? 56 eh? 56 kumpulan Dr. Jadi eh? Dr. Jadi? Eh, dengar tak ni? Doktor?
Saya dengar.
Dia okay. Okay. Kita patut 52 tapi kita ada 43.
Oh, 43. Okay, tak apalah. Yeah. Okay, kita ada 43 kumpulan. Maka kita actually menjangkakan ada 43 kajian kes lah. Kajian kes ni sebenarnya yang akan kita bentangkan kepada pihak kementerian. Jadi para pensyarah yang menjadi mentor perlu memastikan bahawa kajian kes bagi setiap MSE dapat diselesaikan. Sebenarnya benda ni taklah susah tapi taklah mudah. Gitu. Okey, so kajian kes ni bangun oleh setiap kumpulan yang diketuai oleh mentor dan juga para pensyarah penasihat, dan mereka ni bertanggungjawab untuk mendapatkan input dari pelajar dan juga MSE. Okey, penyediaan kajian kes ni perlu mengikut format yang diberikan oleh Pak Ustaz. Saya akan nyatakan sedikit format dia. Template saya belum bagi tapi format format dia dulu, maksudnya apa isi kandungan yang perlu diletakkan dalam kajian kes. Dan kajian kes ni kalau boleh kita tak naklah buat secara macam yang lama, tetapi kita, kalau boleh kita nak jadikan dia sebagai a blend of infographic and information. A blend maksudnya kalau dapat biar benda tu menarik, boleh menggunakan Canva, boleh menggunakan PowerPoint untuk kita produce the report. Saya percaya para mentor yang ada dekat sini dah mahir. Okay, dan maybe boleh orang kata dibangunkan. Ya, yeah, report corporate. Thank you very much. Siapa Dr. Tara eh? It's like a corporate report, dia punya template tu, tetapi ikut creativity, tapi kita hanya bagi template we will give like a common template, but after that up to the team, okay, which is combination of student and lecturers to make sure that it could be delivered lah. And then we actually expect it shouldn't be long report, just comprised of 8 pages, okay, tidak termasuk the front page muka hadapan. Okay, jadi apakah kandungan dia? Sebenarnya sebelum ni dah diberitahu, cuma kita perhalusi lagi. Muka hadapan kajian kes. So muka hadapan tu ada tajuk. Maksudnya by using your creativity, you actually decide the title of the case study. Contoh, okay, maybe kita letak pemerkasaan perniagaan syarikat ABC melalui pemasaran digital. Okay, ataupun from zero to hero. Okay, digitalization of business Ahmad. Macam itu. Okay. So maksudnya gunakan kreativiti untuk letak tajuk supaya bila kita baca kajian kes tu, bila tengok tajuk je orang nak baca. Macam mana dia. Okay. Jadi muka hadapan letakkan title and then letakkan nama mentor dan juga pelajar. Saya panggil perantis lah dekat sini. Nama logo universiti, nama logo MSE. Okay. Setakat ni faham ya? Dr. Yusni faham? Dr. Yusni juga saya panggil. Dr. Sina?
Okay. Faham.
Alhamdulillah. Okey, kemudian ni kajian kes saya semua faham. Okey, kemudian kajian kes tu akan dimulakan dengan sedikit latar belakang usahawan.
Jangan petik nama aje.
Okey. Yeah. Yeah, apa yang ada lah. Siapa yang saya kenal, saya petik namalah. Okey. And then ada latar belakang perniagaan MSE, SME lah panggil sebenarnya. Okey, jadi kita nyatakan latar belakang. So bila dah buat engagement tu, sekarang ni fasa yang pertama ialah berkenalan. So pastikan dapat nama usahawan tu siapa. Okey, bagaimana dia bermula. Okey, contohnya. Okey, dan mungkin kita juga mohon supaya dimasukkan MC sebab nanti saya rasa belum ada sekarang. Dr. Jadi nanti akan ada latihan BMC kan. Okey. Jadi boleh dapatkan data siap-siap supaya nanti boleh dimasukkan dalam kajian kes tersebut. Okey, perkara yang paling penting, sebab bila kita kata kajian kes ni sebenarnya kita nak kenal pasti masalah. Okey, apa sebenarnya masalah yang dihadapi oleh usahawan dalam dia menjalankan perniagaan, terutamanya daripada segi aspek pemasaran atau perniagaan digital. Yang kita nak tahulah sebenarnya kita dah boleh agak beberapa masalah lah yang dihadapi. Contohnya maybe kurang orang, kurang skill dan sebagainya. Jadi sekarang ni kita nak actually validate kenapa dia kurang. Maybe disebabkan oleh umur, mungkin disebabkan oleh faktor-faktor lain. Yang tu kita nak pastikan lah. Okay. Jadi sekarang ni cuba lihat apa sebenarnya dihadapi. Maybe business dia tu meletup. Memang dah okay. Tetapi kita terima Dr. Zaidi. Yang kita terima dalam dua bahasa Dr. Zaidi.
Ya, yeah, kita terima dalam dua bahasa.
Tak ada masalah. Okay, tak ada masalah.
Tapi jangan rojak.
Yes, it should be standardized. Kalau buat dalam bahasa Malaysia, buat bahasa Malaysia. Kalau if you think that you're comfortable to write in English, please proceed in English. Okay, but there's no, it shouldn't be mixed language. And then tak ada orang kata BM saja BI tak. You can actually choose either language lah. Either one. Okay, and then selepas dari orang kata kita kenal pasti masalah ni, sebenarnya sebab tu pelajar ni datang, dia menjadi sebagai ambassador tau. Jadi sekiranya dia kenal pasti masalah tu, macam mana solution yang perlu dipropose? Sebab tu dia ada win-win situation. Pelajar pergi jumpa dengan MSE, pelajar perlu belajar the real business, but at the same time dia juga belajar marketing yang kita berikan, and then dia apply. Okay, apa benda sebenarnya masalah yang dihadapi. Okay, contohnya maybe kita baru nampak, oh sebenarnya dia kurang orang, dia tak ada website, dia tak ada knowledge, dia tak ada duit nak buat, contoh. Okay, so benda tu yang kita kena pastilah. Jadi sekarang ni antara benda yang kita nak lihat ialah sejauh mana sebenarnya kumpulan yang ada ni cuba mencadangkan, membangunkan penyelesaian masalah tu pun solusi dekat situ. Okey, contohnya dia bangunkan website. Contohnya dia ajar, okey dia nampak dekat sini dia tak tahu macam mana nak menggunakan WhatsApp for business. Okey, dekat situ contohnya kita ajar usahawan tu, okey sekarang ni saya nak ajar macam mana nak guna WhatsApp for business. Okey, macam mana nak guna Instagram, ataupun saya percaya adik-adik dekat sini sangat hebat menggunakan TikTok. Sangat hebat menggunakan Reel on Instagram. Kan Dr. Yusni, Dr. Yusni ni orang Reel. Okey. Jadi maybe pelajar tu sendiri yang kata propose a creative content for the business, for the entrepreneurs. Okay, buatlah TikTok. Tu contohnya lah. Okay, buatkan content, buatkan jadual. Contohnya kadang-kadang bila kita buat Instagram ataupun buat apa nama dia, social media marketing ni, sebenarnya untuk business ni dia ada jadual. Hari ni apa? Hari ni apa? Hari ni pasal sharing info. Hari ni pasal sharing something else. Okay, pasal produk. Okey, mungkin tidak bergesan boleh untung tapi dapat tidak maksimal. Okey, okey, itu Dr. Lady ada propose tu. Very good. Okey. And then satu MSc 3 pelajar, betul Dr. Lin. Okey, satu MSc 3 pelajar. Ha, mereka ni actually work as a team. Ah, betul Dr. Tara, social media calendar, betul. Benda tu memang kita boleh propose. Okey, as simple as kita propose calendar, sebab kadang-kadang for them to create a content it might take some time. So you actually develop a template for the MSE, and then at the same time you also propose the draft for the timetable lah, macam tadi social media calendar. Hari apa yang dia kena actually aktif. Contohnya hari Sabtu pagi contoh ha. Jadi kita yang propose, kita actually become the advisor for the business, but at the same time we actually learning from them lah. Okay. And then daripada kita punya aspek yang kita propose ni, sebab itu kita actually letakkan para pelajar untuk dengan bersama usahawan dalam masa 2-3 bulan eh Dr. Zaidi, sekurang-kurangnya 40 jam perlu ada engagement dekat dalam logbook. Malam ni tak ada logbook lagi sebenarnya. Malam ni kita tak buat direct engagement dengan usahawan. Perantis tak ada buat engagement dengan usahawan. Okay, jadi kita hanya kira jumlah jam bila berdasarkan engagement di antara perantis. Perantis lah, sebab nama program ni sebenarnya Impact Digital Entrepreneurship Apprentice. Ah, tu dia. Jadi adik-adik yang dekat sini sebenarnya adalah apprentice. Ah, jadi apprentice. Apprentice lah bahasa Melayu dia kan. Okay, apprentice. Okay, jadi bila masa kita propose sekarang ni, the next part yang kita kena ada, dan saya nasihatkan lah, kita kena kajian impact keberkesanan ni maybe ada dua cara lah. Yang pertama secara kualitatif, yang kedua secara kuantitatif. Okay, so maybe untuk permulaan, maybe para advisor boleh bangunkan a simple survey. Contoh simple survey tu sejauh mana dia punya knowledge dalam social media di kalangan micro enterprise. Okay, dan habis daripada program ni, engagement dengan para pelajar, apa impact yang dia ada. Maksudnya kita nak actually highlight pre and post. Itu salah satunya. Yang kedua, maybe boleh menggunakan kaedah yang checklist ataupun observation. Tapi sekarang ni observation kita tak boleh pergi tempat tu lah. Tapi maybe boleh observe Facebook dia macam mana. Sekarang ni para pelajar kena tengok dia dari Facebook. Saya nampak tadi dalam senarai usahawan mikro yang MSE yang mendaftar, ada dia punya Facebook, ada dia punya Instagram, ada punya website. So why not untuk permulaan bedah dahulu bagaimana keadaan dia punya Facebook tu, adakah dia punya copywriting sebenarnya boleh ditingkatkan, macam mana nak pastikan dia lagi om. Bila orang baca copywriting tu lagi om, kadang-kadang bukan apa, saya kadang-kadang kita tengok orang yang yalah, sebab kita tak belajar kadang-kadang copywriting, macam mana nak tarik orang, macam mana nak pastikan orang baca. Maybe usahawan ni dia promote belilah barang saya, maybe dia post dia gambar, tapi sekarang ni peranan mentor dan juga apprentice yang ada dekat sini, macam mana nak bantu dia supaya dia boleh dapat edit gambar, dia buat copywriting, macam mana nak attract, macam mana nak share, macam mana nak post dan sebagainya, dan macam mana dia buat reel, macam gitu. Okey, bila buat reel tu apa benda ni yang dia ada, apa lagu yang kena ada. Kan sekarang ni contoh saya tengok sekarang ni, kalau dekat reel tu ataupun TikToks, okey, dia ada macam lagu and then one shot with 8 close. Contoh siapa yang dapat usahawan jual baju tu, banyak reel boleh buat. Jadi gunakan reel tersebut, bila orang tengok wow. Okey, itu sebenarnya tujuan apprentice yang ada dekat sini, bantu usahawan ni supaya dia dapat wow. Dan collect data tu, okay? Dan sebab tu bila ada dekat sini, barulah kita boleh kaji ke impact keberkesanan. Impact keberkesanan kena start daripada awal, okay? Maksudnya sekarang antara yang kita boleh lihat, yang pertama Facebook tu berapa ramai? Kalau kalau sekarang 300, maybe dalam masa 2 bulan, para pelajar ni boleh bantu jadi 3,000. Daripada 300 viewer, daripada 300 likers, followers jadi 3,000. Ha, itu impact yang boleh dikira juga. Jadi itulah kita ni nak bantu satu sama lain lah sebenarnya. Jadi tolong promote, tolong kreatkan konten, ajar macam mana kepada usahawan mikro, macam mana nak create konten tu. Okay, jadi bila kita boleh push impact keberkesanan ni, barulah nampak program ni betul. Jadi sebab tu kita namakan program ni Impact Digital Entrepreneurship Apprentice. Dan para pelajar boleh belajar, orang kata knowledge tu direct daripada kita punya SME, okay, subject matter expert yang kita dah jadual, dan juga boleh belajar directly macam mana peniagaan pembangunan produk oleh usahawan yang kita yang tuan dan pensyarah dah pilih, mesti dah pilih. Itu barulah buat kesimpulan dan cadangan. Jadi senang cerita, walaupun benda tu 8 pages kepada para pensyarah dekat sini, tapi pastikan benda tu memang boom, meletup. Itu yang kita nak. Okay. Boleh Dr. Sina, Dr. ni, siapa lagi nama saya nak petik ni? Okay. Boleh, Dr. Sabrina.
Dr. Omar.
Ya, saya.
Boleh tanya soalan?
Boleh.
Kalau kami approach, contohnya lah, this is for propaganda lah sebenarnya. Nak supaya program kita ni lebih dikenali. Contohnya macam saya punya SCM dekat Kedah contohnya lah. Jadi saya collaborate dengan apa tu Menteri Besar Kedah umpamanya, jadi kita ada, kita buat satu projek lah, KPT sedang berusaha sama lah dengan UiTM, kita nak bangunkan satu syarikat konon-kononnya lah yang kita nak bagi dia pendedahan mengenai digital punya ni. Jadi kita collaborate dengan dia orang untuk benda ni diwar-warkan dalam dia punya warta ke, boleh ke apa tu Dr. Omar?
Pandangan peribadi saya, tak ada masalah Dr. Zaidi, tak ada masalah kan Dr. Zaidi? Dr. Zaidi selaku ketua projek, Dr. Zaidi. Rasa lagi bagus macam itu, Dr. Zaidi.
Saya tak ambil. Tak ada masalah. The most important thing, for example, sebab even ada a few kawan kita yang bila nampak program saya ni, program kita ni, mereka memang nak gunakan program ni, leverage untuk mereka dapat network yang besar lah. So kalau tuan boleh buat, tak ada masalah. The only thing for the time being, memang dari segi supervisor, tuan just handle tuan punya team lah untuk capai objektif program. Kalau tuan nak gunakan dia, for example, next time kita nak collaborate, kita memang open for that lah. Kita tak ada masalah.
Betul. Kita dekatkan yang penting.
Okay, thank you.
Yang penting benda tu berimpact tuan. Okay, itu yang paling pentingnya lah. Okay, tak kisahlah sebenarnya, bergantung kepada kreativiti kumpulan tu macam mana nak bantu. Up to the level, kalau dia fikir dia nak actually menggunakan teknik seafood MBS tu kan, seafood bags, okay, ataupun nak gunakan Najib Asadok, go ahead. Okay, apa yang ada dekat sini sebagai foundation, tapi if you guys want to explore more, leverage your network and then connect with other businessman, it's okay. As long as kita dapat bantu usahawan yang telah ditindikkan, yang telah diberikan tanggungjawab kepada kita. Itulah dia sebenarnya. Okay. Benda ni sebenarnya kita akan nilai daripada kisah ini macam mana. Tetapi bila masa kenapa ada assignment seterusnya adalah kita kena actually prepare. Selepas daripada 8 page tu, ni pergi kepada yang kedua. Kita kena prepare poster digital. Poster ni senang cerita, kita cuba summarize-kan daripada 8 page yang kita ada, jadilah 1 page. Dan benda inilah sebenarnya nanti kita akan orang kata buat showcase. Sebenarnya by right, kalaulah kita doakan COVID-19 ni reda, maybe akan ada ruang dan peluang untuk kita hadiri showcase. Maybe. Kalau tak ada pun, showcase tu akan dibuat secara digital. Jadi yang tu kita akan orang kata buat melalui macam inilah, Zoom Live kan, FB Live dan sebagainya. Kita tunjukkan kita punya sampel dan bentangkan kepada respected orang kata audience. Okay. Dia adalah summary of apa yang kita telah buat dalam report tadi, dalam case tadi. Okay. Dan sama juga content dia, kita, yang ni tak ada sampel dia tengok kat format ni, sama jugalah tak belakang MSC, BMC, maybe BMC taklah nak letak satu BMC ni, just summarizekan apa isu, apa benda yang penting, and then masalah cabaran, apa penyelesaian dan solution yang telah diproposkan, buat kajian impact keberkesanan, kesimpulan dan cadangan. Itulah dia sebenarnya. Sebenarnya ni adalah dia punya continuation ataupun kita actually put everything in a nutshell dalam kita punya orang kata poster digital ni. Okay, ada soalan lain tak? Ada soalan? Faham eh? Faham tak? Thumbs up semua supaya saya boleh sambung seterusnya. Faham tak? Sekarang dah pukul 9.49. Saya cuba habiskan pukul 10. Okay. Ada soalan?
Faham. Yes,
faham. Bos, Azri. Saya dengar suara Azri tu. Okay. Azri ke tu?
Bukan orang lain.
Dia Umar.
Doktor.
Yes, please.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Doctor, yes, I want to ask about the masalah and cabaran. Is it the masalah and cabaran is they are facing now or the past?
What I mean the current problems. So when you engage with them right now, try to actually communicate with them or asking them directly. Ataupun you actually can identify through your observation. Okay. Most probably, like I said, one of the things that you can do, please go to their social media. Okay. For example, the Facebook, their Instagram, or TikTok, whatsoever. Try to assess their content. Is it the content is powerful? Is it the content still need to be improved? So this is something that you can propose. You got it? Okay. So the current situation, because we want to examine the impact of your assistant, that means as a consultant, I'm going to say that you need to act as a young consultant, try to help this MSE, okay, to be better in terms of digital marketing. Faham eh? Sheng daripada mana ni? Where are you from?
Yes. From UMS.
Oh, UMS from Sabah. Okay. Good question. Okay. Okay, so am I answering your question, Sheng?
Yes, thank you.
Okay. I'm going to proceed to the next part. Sekiranya pukul 10, saya jadi hodoh. So, saya kena laju sikit. Okay. So, the next part is actually we focus on the NISPI, okay? Video story. This is one of the important part. But video story, basically, we're going to do towards the end of the program. Okay? Again, this is referring to the penghasilan video creator. Yang memfokuskan kepada hasil pelaksanaan program idea at KPT, maksudnya your project, terutamanya kita nak highlight kesan positif kepada para usahawan MSC dan perantis. So dalam video tersebut yang ni actually student kena bangunkan, student yang kena develop this kind of project lah. Nanti kita akan ada hadiah, video kreatif ni, Dr. Zaidi. Saya rasa lumayan juga hadiahnya. Nanti dia akan reveal. Hadiah dia sangat lumayan. Okay. Tapi taklah percutian ke Mauritius. Tak ada. Jangan anggap bentuk percutian. Tidak. Okay. InsyaAllah dalam bentuk wang ringgit. Okay. Jadi video tu perlu fokus pada aspek-aspek yang berikut lah. Maksudnya you all kena kreatif untuk letakkan dalam masa 5 minit maksimum. Okay. 5 minit maksimum. You boleh buat 1 minit, you boleh buat 2 minit, you boleh buat 3 minit as long as the video does not exceed 5 minutes duration. Okay? So what need to be highlight? Okay, what need to be highlighted on the video? First, definitely you need to introduce you punya project bersama perantis dan juga usahawan. Okay? And then definitely in order to highlight the impact, first of all, try to highlight what basically the challenges and barriers, okay, experienced by the MSE, particularly with regard to the digital marketing. Okay, you kena highlight, and then apa yang you bantu, sebenarnya solution you. Apa sebenarnya strategi pemasaran digital yang you all propose. Contohnya, buatlah macam some kind of dramatic scene, okay. Macam mana dia actually start dengan sendu je dia punya business, and then with the what we call it, emergence of digital marketing. So the business boom, okay? So this is something yang you can highlight dalam that video, okay? And then maybe towards the end, you also need to highlight the positive impact to the SME as well as to you, okay? You boleh masuk kat situ apa yang you belajar, then any kind of thing that you think relevant that could attract the attention and give some kind of important information to the audience, okay? Inilah video dia, okay? Ada soalan lain? Okay, jadi video ni cari bahan daripada sekarang lah, sebab nanti dia sebenarnya kita boleh olah daripada kisah yang kita bangunkan. Dalam masa yang sama, kita cuba actually highlight. Saya percayalah sebenarnya video tu lagi better sebenarnya begini kalau kita boleh pergi ke tempat usahawan. Tetapi why not? Okay, kalau kita sebabkan kita ada restriction movement orders, kita ada limitation daripada segi movement nak ke MSC usahawan punya tempat, minta tolong usahawan tu supaya dia rekodkan beberapa video. Contohnya kita tak dapat pergi dia punya kilang, tak dapat tengok dia punya proses, tak dapat tengok dia punya produk, tak dapat tengok cara dia buat pemasaran. Start daripada sekarang, you all minta dia actually orang kata rekodkan video pendek je sebenarnya, video-video pendek. Okay, maybe dalam 10 saat, 15 saat, 30 saat ataupun up to them lah. Yang penting you kena edit nanti. Okay, so nanti kita akan compilekan, jadikan bahan cerita supaya benda tu menarik. Okay, and then ya, ni kita punya template lah. Nanti upload dah siap video tu ya, tuan-tuan dan puan-puan, adik-adik yang dekat sini. Ni tugas-tugas adik-adik apprentice ni, adik-adik apprentice kat sini kena upload that video. Okay, so tentatively saya tak dapat lagi approval daripada bos saya, Dr. Lady. Boleh macam ni, Dr. Lady? Kita ini at KPT tuan-tuan, project ni. Okay, letak yeah, macam itu. Okay,
kita memang prepare satu platform untuk you upload. Yes.
Okay. So that means the title should be standard like this. Nanti we going to share lah benda ni, nanti kita akan perhalusi, kita akan yes, share
tentatively, including, eh, including hashtag semua kita akan bagi.
Yes, saya lupa nak suruh letak hashtag. So basically dalam that video, ni kalau you all upload you go to the YouTube channel, studio, we call it studio. Nanti you kena, you upload video, dia akan letak, dia suruh minta letak description. Okay, so letak dekat sini title video you, and then description. Apa description nak kena tulis kat situ? Okay, kena tulis brief explanation of the project. Okay, that mean highlight, for example, few things. Okay, this is a group of what we call it UMS champion. Okay, that has been attacked to this company, okay, that work together, blah blah blah, you boleh buat lah cerita you. Okay, and eventually to the end of the project, these are the impact rated. Letaklah sikit, okay, tapi janganlah buat karangan panjang, tak, okay, description ni pendek je sebenarnya, supaya diorang tahu, kita tahu apa actually kisah di sebalik video yang dia upload tu, okay. And then do not forget to put your name, list of members, to the name, lecturer's name, as well as MSC name, and I forget to put here, put hashtag, okay, put hashtag, okay, hashtag idea KPT21. Okay, letaklah hashtag apa-apa saja yang actually boleh attract people to visit the video. Okay, kita akan lihat juga video ni ada juga dia punya hadiah, ada juga dia punya competition. So we going to actually assess the best video, definitely not from us because saya pun jadi advisor juga. Okay, tapi saya percaya yang dekat sini semua adalah hebat-hebat. Dr. Yul, Dr. Azri, Dr. Izati, Dr. siapa lagi yang ada dekat sini? Dr. Samsina, Dr. Din, so on and so forth lah. Okay, so ramai yang ada dekat sini, saya rasa semua tu memang meletup. You all adik-adik kat sini, tolong actually attach diri you dengan orang kata coach-coach daripada usahawan ni, usahawan daripada pensyarah yang boleh bantu. Mereka ni semua sebenarnya hebat. Okay, and then you can use any kind of theme. Paling mudah buat PowerPoint recording, you can use Viva Video, iMovie, Quick Vlog It. Okay, so there's a lot of tools that you can use to produce the video. But make sure that the video does not exceed 5 minutes. Saya rasa tu sahaja. Ada soalan tak? Saya pukul 10 saya jadi hodoh, so saya kena stop sekarang. Ada soalan tak? Tak apa-apa. Mesti ada soalan tak?
Cancel ke pukul 10?
Okay, ada soalan. YouTube video story as public. Oh, mestilah public. Jangan unlisted. Kita nak public. Sebab apa kita nak you all public? Okay. Sebab untuk jadi hebat, kita kena public. Saya rasa saya tak lah. Gini. Sebab semua kebanyakan yang view training MDEC ni, dia kena buat FB live. Ingat tak dulu-dulu? Puan-puan, Dr. Azri, ingat tak?
Ingat sangat.
Ingat. Fobia.
Jadi sekarang ni, nak melatih adik-adik yang ada dekat sini ni untuk buat FB live juga.
Ya ke fobia? Kita tak percaya je fobia tu.
Ya, benci ya.
Ada Dr. Helmi kat sini. Dr. Helmi ingat tak, Dr. Helmi buat FB live dulu? Dr. Helmi, are you there? Rakan saya Dr. Helmi, lama tak jumpa.
Terketak-ketak kita nak buat.
Ingat, okay. Jadi sekarang ni kita nak cerita, semua yang kita buat ni adik-adik semua, apprentice, all the apprentice here, kita kena mencapap. Mencapap, you know what the meaning of mencapap? Mencari publicity. Sebab kita kena buat benda ni public. Sebab itu kena make it public. Okay. So you need to learn the word of mencapap. From now on, whatever thing that you do, even tonight, kita buat benda ni, ambil lah gambar, upload hashtag. Hashtag KPT to, idea at KPT21. Mencapap everything. Okay. Sebab kita akan nilai lah siapa yang paling mencapap. Kita ada hadiah, Dr. Lady. Mencapap pula.
Yeah.
Siapa yang lagi visible? Siapa yang boleh actually make sure the business visible to others? People know about that. So we actually give some acknowledgement. So don't be shy. Okay, bila dalam media sosial ni sebenarnya saya sebenarnya malu. Saya pemalu, tapi dalam media sosial saya boleh jadi orang yang extrovert. Tak ada masalah. So sebab orang tak kenal siapa kita, don't be shy. Okay. Okay, saya rasa that's actually my sharing. I'm going to open to the question. Any more question ada kita? Saya pun mencari publicity.
Ada question sini.
Okay, good. Question.
Doktor ada question tentang licensing untuk YouTube tu. Licensing CC ataupun YouTube standard license?
Doktor Zaidi, soal jawapan dia apa? I think it's more open lah kot.
Okay. Doktor Zaidi?
Yeah. Sekejap ya.
Standard license, kalau boleh sebab the content, we're going to check regarding this. The content is actually developed by you.
The most important thing when you develop the content, the material that you use, for example, recording, music, and so on, okay, must be an open public one. If you use those which is claimed, nanti once you submit, kita ada pernah experience, submit less than 24 hours, you can see student dah happy dah submit, suddenly it was taken down by YouTube. Okay, so the student were not able to have dia punya show tu untuk di assess untuk markah lah. Yes, no copyright content. So all must be open lah.
Okay, ada orang tanya saya, dia kata ada MSE, MSE ni kan ada yang juga small. Okay, so kalau dia punya tu dah 90,000, 100,000 followers, macam mana nak naikkan lagi? Okay, naikkanlah lagi. Tapi basically, dia gini. You all kena actually capture what's basically the current followers or likers. But that not the definite ways of assessing. Bukan tu satu cara je. Banyak cara lain yang kita akan assess lah nanti. Okay. How visible the business is. Okay. Boleh the visibility of the business. Saya rasa semua kat sini boleh bantu. Macam contohnya kalau macam Dr. Azri punya business dah sampai 8,000. Jadi dia punya task jadikan benda ni sebagai 1 juta. Ataupun 8 juta standard dengan Nelofa. Gitu boleh. Okay. So the rubric. Do you have the rubric for the assessment? Basically, we don't have a specific rubric for now. Adalah sebenarnya. So basically, untuk template tu you just follow. But for the activity, that's why we actually going to see. For example, kita sebenarnya gini. You kena first. There's no standard rubric in the sense that setiap business level yang berbeza. Kita tak tahu sekarang ni. That's why the first thing that you need to do is actually make engagement with the usahawan, with the entrepreneurs and see what's the current level. Itulah dia. Sebenarnya kita nak tengok the impact. Okay. So from today, 1st of June, and then what will be the impact by the end of August. So within 3 months, so what will be the impact? Okay. So maybe we're going to see in terms of the percentage of orang kata followers increase, okay, from July to August, ataupun sales. So ada lagi, there are few things lah yang kita akan tengok. Nanti kita akan share the rubric, don't worry. But the rubric will be general, tak semestinya kita tengok percentage jugalah, okay. Betul doktor ? Rindu separuh nyawa drama ke? Okay, boleh. Tak ada rindu separuh nyawa.
Ada yang tulis rindu separuh nyawa. Saya pun tak tahu apa tu.
Okay. Saya rasa sekarang tengah ada drama.
Drama. Tengah ada drama. Tengah saya follow drama tu.
apa cerita sekarang?
Apa Yusni?
Tahu. Saya tahu. Saya tampak.
Boleh. Tak ada masalah. You letaklah hashtag drama. You rindu separuh nyawa ke apa lagi. Whatsoever yang you boleh buat lah. Okay, ada soalan lain tak? Any more questions?
Ada soalan hebat ni. Kalau MSc lebih bijak daripada student.
Kalau
MSc lebih bijak daripada student.
Dia mesti ada something yang MSc tu. Sebab tu you kena tahu apa benda MSc yang boleh dibantu. Saya tak kata MSc tu tak hebat. Maybe MSc yang you approach tu tak hebat. So macam mana nak dia jadi lagi mega? Lagi wow, lagi world standard. Tu dia. Okay, itu dia punya impact. Okay, sebab kita memang pemilihan MSC ni maybe is actually diverse. Dia tidak tertakluk kepada yang biasa-biasa, maybe ada luar biasa yang ada extraordinary. So yang tu yang you all kena lihat lah. Boleh? Okay. Boleh? Okay. Saya terlepas tengok ada, drama. Saya ada drama soalan,
ada soalan?
Ada soalan?
Link video. Okey, saya akan, kita akan letakkan link video tu dekat web sebab untuk pengetahuan semua boleh refer pada timeline. Timeline ada. Video ni bukan nak submit dalam masa sebulan dari sekarang. Ada masa lagi. Okay. So, dia kita bagi awal ni supaya anda semua boleh prepare lah. Whatever journey yang you buat, you boleh record and just starting develop you punya design, you punya storyboard and so on. Okay. Betul. Tapi all the links apa kita akan bagi nanti dalam web. Website kita semua maklumat dalam tu. Alright. Don't worry.
Okay.
Semua terbakar dah. Semua dah terbakar tu. Tak sabar.
Semua
dah
semua nak menang. Itu belum terbakar lagi. Nanti Dr. Zaidi akan announce hadiah-hadiah. Base case study berapa dapat, base video berapa dapat. Okay. Base poster berapa dapat. Kan Dr. Zaidi? Okay.
Betul.
Lagi satu yang kita belum share malam ni, kita don't release yet, adalah report. Yang tu nanti kita akan share lagi lah pasal report. Okay. So yang tu sebenarnya sedikit lah. Sebab tu kita nak program ni impactful. Sebab tu nama program ni Impact Digital Entrepreneurship Apprentice. You jadi apprentice sebenarnya. Okay. Okay, ada soalan lain tak? Semua-semua sekali ni Dr. Olin tak menang pun dapat duit. Hari tu cakap kita tak boleh lah beritahu. Sebab kadang-kadang benda surprise ni orang suka Dr. Olin. Okay, ada. InsyaAllah adalah sedikit hadiah yang
teaser,
boleh kita
Teaser.
Kan? Yang 1000 tu case study. Once you siap case study, you dapat lah. That's actually for the pensyarah, pastikan siap. Okay, tetapi kita ada pertanyaan. That means ada the best of the best case. Contoh. Okay, and then ada the best video. Contoh, itu dia. Yang tu kita akan keluarkan. Ni baru teaser. Kan? Okay? Okay, so ada soalan lain tak semua? Okay? Dr. Sabrina, Dr. siapa lagi, Dr. Yus, ada soalan tak?
I'm okay, Dr. Umar, thank you.
Okay, saya panggil Dr. sebab itu daripada UTM. Dr. Abdillah ada tak? My sahabat ada? Ada soalan lain tak?
Tak ada lah, Dr. Umar. Okay, buat macam ni.
Okay, kalau tak ada, saya rasa itu sahaja. Saya doakan yang baik-baik kepada semua. Jaga diri dan saya pass it over to my boss, Dr. Zaidi.
Okay, Dr. Umar, thank you. Okay, first thing, I'm not your boss. Kita klik. Okay, kita will do together. Okay, guys, so thank you very much. I think last time, ada sedikit yang saya tak share ataupun saya dah share tapi some of you may not get it. Okay, firstly, I like to remind again, everyone will be getting allowance. Student will be getting RM400 per person. So this is equivalent to like, we call it like because you have 40 hours, okay, so 1 hour is RM10, so you will be getting for 400. Pendaftaran perniagaan dengan co-working space, kita akan bagi allowance RM600 per team, okay, per team in West Malaysia, and RM700 for team in Sabah and Sarawak. Untuk pensyarah, we will be getting kajian case RM1,000, kajian case punya allowance. And then there's another one, okay, perjumpaan dengan MSE. MSE ni kita akan bagi, for example, you need to meet. Normally, this is what we do in business. We need to have like networking meeting, networking. Sometimes if I meet my kawan usahawan pun, sometimes sebelum saya pergi singgah dekat Shell. Saya pergi beli 2 ketul, 3 ketul nasi lemak, bawa pergi depan, bagi dia lah. Dia pun happy. Dia cakap, oh doktor, saya tak makan lagi. Macam you faham je. Yes, saya tahu. You're busy. You makan lah. Saya beli untuk you, baru kita boleh start cerita. So that is adalah RM600 sana. So if you see, it's around RM3,400 per pasukan. That's a lot of money. So we try our best to make sure that we cater so that you can get macam, apa nama, at least can cover the some of the cost that you require to use. Okay. So itu saja. I think tak ada lagi . Tak ada lagi . Oh, banyak chat ni.
Excuse me, doctor.
Okay, silakan.
I have a question for the, let's say, the co-working space. How do we actually apply for the funding?
Oh, co-working space, what we do, you have to go and get which co-working space that you want to assign, you want to sit. Okay, so you won't be able to get a long duration for co-working space because it's expensive. Okay, so if let's say you manage to get, for example, like maybe RM200, okay, RM200 per your 3 person or 2 person, okay, you can sit there and then you can give the receipt to the university. Sebab all the funding will go to your pusat keusahawanan. Okay, So like you yourself in UTM, so Pusat Keusahawanan will be in UTM, UTM Excite. They will actually see whether you, for example, pendaftaran perniagaan, you did it in SSM, you dapat receipt co-working space, dia akan bayar lah pada you. Allowance kita akan directly bagi once you complete you punya logbook. Alright? Kajian case the same. Once kajian case siap, kita akan bagi the 1,000. Perjumpaan dengan MSC, currently kita still dalam discussion, tapi kita cadangkan kepada all the funding kita pass pada pusat, pusat yang akan jaga how to disburse the money. Okay?
Alright, thank you, Doktor.
Hmm. Assalamualaikum.
Okay.
Saya Dr. Mel daripada UUM. Saya ada satu soalan berkaitan dengan pendaftaran perniagaan tu. Okey, dekat situ ada allowance kan? So yang pendaftaran perniagaan ni, duit ni adalah untuk usahawan yang belum berdaftar ke ataupun untuk pelajar yang berminat untuk berdaftar perniagaan selepas tamat program ni?
Untuk pelajar saja. Duit semua funding-funding kita ni, doktor, ada dua yang memang selalu orang tanya. Satu is untuk siapa pendaftaran perniagaan dan co-working space, memang untuk pelajar. Yang kedua, perjumpaan dengan MSC tu sebenarnya kita, you kena keep lah the money. For example, nak beli some food ke apa ke, nak untuk chit-chat ke, macam nak develop rapport, it's you. Not to give the funding to MSC. Okay? So, because the funding is from Kementerian. Okay, doktor? Thank you. Yeah, betul. Kalau semua buat online digital, yes. Dapat allowance, betul. Allowance 400 memang layak dapat ni, asal you register, you make sure that your logbook is complete lah.
Betul.
Alright.
40 jam kan, doktor?
So yes, 1 jam, 40 jam within 2 months. So memang best student. Memang sekarang ni ada free, okay? Tapi ada free lah register SSM. Okay, so kalau you boleh guna the free, it's okay, no problem. Okay? And you can use the balance for your co-working space. So we don't have you. It's the money is for you. Okay. Bukti perjumpaan dengan SME for the time being. Whatever it is, the student yang buat logbook tu dia kena discuss dengan supervisor lah. So logbook student, lecturer student akan fill up logbook. Supervisor will look at the logbook and then all the everything on the discussion is from supervisor and student. So the student must be jujur. The lecturer must understand that the student is doing their job and it's validated lah, hanya betul lah. Okay, dalam digital sekarang ni dia punya cara bekerja memang tak sama. Dia tak macam kita bekerja face to face, kita kena tengok muka dia punch and so on. So we don't actually know who is behind there and here. So at least these three students will have a supervisor lah to actually see. To discuss and tell the story we were with MSC and so on. Yeah, okay. Sheng tanya, Sheng, if we prepare receipt. Okay, this is a very good question. Please, if you have receipt, please keep it. Okay, this is also a culture because whatever it is that you do and you are in the program, try to keep receipt. It's the same for usahawan. That's why we need bookkeeping because usahawan also sometimes dia tanya perlu saya keluar bill ke, perlu saya keluar receipt ke. So that is the thing that we want to create the culture. Okay, once you have that, then you can easily, for example, you have your evidence lah. Betul, Dr. Alin. Yeah. Itu untuk ni saja ya, Dr. Alin. Nanti ada lagi benda-benda lain yang kita akan bagi pada universiti . Sebab ini hanya untuk team saja. Untuk universiti dia ada yang lain. Dia ada for example ketua zon punya macam-macam lah. Okay, itu saya deal dengan directly dengan Pusat Keusahawanan. Ya, pekerja pun perlu untuk claim income tax. Correct. 7 years kena keep all the record, all the evidence. So you know when we go through this program, we will learn bit by bit. So it's about developing awareness and so on. Meow meow. Okay, so itu saja. Thank you, Brother Dean. Miao-miao semua dah tidur dah. Okay, so I think that's all. So please make sure that you put your attendance attendance dalam the form tadi. Okay, I don't know how many we have, tapi I think we have a lot already putting dia ni. Okay, so it's already 10:15. Kita ni selalu overshoot. Saya minta maaf banyak-banyak. Semua memang rasa bersemangat sangat. Okay, so anything, if you have any question and so on, please put it in the Ketua Zone, your zone, your group, your work. Oh, sorry, your WhatsApp group with your Ketua Zone. And then whatever it is they can answer, they directly answer to you, or whatever it is that they couldn't answer, they will pass it. We have our group Ketua Zone discussion, and I'm going to pass the answer to you lah. Okay, so without further ado, I would like to end, make it a day for today. And jangan lupa tomorrow ada latihan. Untuk siapa latihan besok, jangan lupa tengok pada jadual, look at the timetable dekat training schedule for tomorrow. Tomorrow is for Northern, 4 hari bulan ni, digital business planning Northern. Okay, and Central One pun sama. Okay, and also East Coast. Okay, so tomorrow empat-empat team ni akan masuk dalam latihan digital business planning. Okay, di bawah Coach Azizi dan Coach Shukran. So what you do later on, you just go to view detail. Okay, and we are going to put the information here. Okay, so the link for your Zoom and also link for the attendance, like what we did today. Tonight, okay. Alright, so itu saja daripada kami. Okay, so thank you very much all, and Dr. Sina, thank you to you also. Thank you everyone. Okay, and please take care, stay safe. Okay, please make sure don't become victim for don't bersubahat also victim for COVID. Okay, so please take care, because we want you, we love you, we want you to be in our program until finish. Okay. So thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and bye-bye.
Waalaikumsalam.
Bye.
Yes, Yazibu.
Thank you, Rata.
Thank you.
Hello, Dr. Chadi.